Based on its javadoc, a Java util list is supposed to represent an ordered collection of values, but that's not necessarily the case if you use it as the type of a too-many association or an element collection. As I explained before, Hibernate can handle a Java util list as a bag or a list. Only the list mapping persists the order of its elements, but by default, Hibernate handles a Java util list as a bag. After you have fetched it from the database, it contains the elements in an undefined order. Until Hibernate 6, you had to add an order column annotation to your element collection one-to-many association or the owning side of your many-to-many association to persist the order of your Java util list. Hibernate then persists the position of each element in a separate column and manages the index of all elements during all insert, update, and delete operations. Please note that the order column annotation is not supported for the referencing side of many-to-many associations. Since Hibernate 6, you can define the list semantics globally for the owning side of your many-to-many associations and element collections by setting the configuration property hibernate.mapping.defaultListSemantics to list in your persistence.xml. If you want to apply the same handling to your one-to-many associations, you still have to add an order column annotation. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen. If you want to build incredibly efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring Data JPA, please subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful. Let's take a closer look at this new configuration parameter and the implications of managing and persisting the index of each element in the list. By default, Hibernate doesn't persist the order of the elements of any element collection or too-many association. You can change that in two ways. You can either configure it globally or adjust the handling of a specific attribute. When doing that, please keep in mind that the global setting doesn't affect the referencing side of a one-to-many or many-to-many association. Since Hibernate 6, you can set the property hibernate.mapping.defaultListSemantics in your persistence.xml configuration to list. Hibernate then treats your element collection and the owning side of your many-to-many association in the same ways as if you annotated them with order column. It persists the position of each element in a separate database column. To get the name of that column, Hibernate adds the postfix _order to the name of the column that maps the association. Let's use this in a simple test scenario based on the following chess player and chess tournament entities. As you can see, there is nothing special about these two entity classes. Both use a database sequence to generate their primary key values and a version attribute for optimistic locking. The configured list semantics will affect the many-to-many association, modeled by the player's attribute of the chess tournament entity. When you execute the following test case, you can see that Hibernate stores each chess player's position in the list players in the player's order column. When Hibernate fetches the list of players, it doesn't use an order by clause to get the players in the right order, but orders them in memory instead. Persisting the order of the elements of an association might sound like a great idea, but it requires a management effort that can slow down your write operations. Because Hibernate persists each element's position, it has to update multiple records if you're adding or removing any element that's not the last one in the list. In the previous examples, I added an element to the end of the list. That didn't require any changes to the index of the other elements. But that changes when you add an element somewhere in the middle. By adding the chess player on position 1, the index of all elements that were on position 1 or higher gets incremented by 1. Hibernate then needs to update that in the database. And the same, of course, happens if you remove any element except for the last one. As you can see in this example, persisting the order of the list creates an overhead. Depending on the size of the list and the kind of operations you perform, this can cause severe performance problems. I therefore recommend sticking to Hibernate's old list semantics and using the new handling with great care. A list is supposed to be an ordered collection of elements, but by default, Hibernate doesn't persist the order, and the database returns the elements in a random order. But due to that, the initial order of the elements is lost after Hibernate fetches the list from the database. Previous to Hibernate 6, you can avoid that by annotating your element collection one-to-many association or the owning side of your many-to-many association with an order column annotation. Hibernate then stores the position of each element in a separate database column. Since Hibernate 6, you can use a new configuration parameter to change the handling of your lists globally for all your element collections and the owning sides of your many-to-many associations. To do that, you only need to set the hibernate.mapping.default list semantics configuration property to list. When you decide to persist the order of your lists, please keep in mind that this can slow down your write operations. Hibernate needs to manage the index of all list elements, which requires multiple update operations if you're inserting or removing an element that's not the last one. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate and JPA, you should join the Persistence Hub. It gives you access to all my video courses, including one about Hibernate performance tuning, 2 monthly Q&A calls, monthly coding challenges, a community of like-minded developers, and regular expert sessions. And if you like today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!